Dear learner, I welcome you in this live session of Facebook. So today I am going to discuss about the network theory. In this particular lecture, we will discuss different problems and their solution. So in the previous lecture, we have discussed different laws like Kirchhoff's voltage law, Kirchhoff's current law, and we have also discussed how to apply the mesh analysis, nodal analysis. Then we have discussed different network theorem, like Thevenin theorem, superposition theorem, Norton theorem, and also maximum power transfer theorem. So in this particular lecture, we will consider some examples and we will analyze the circuit with help of different theorems. So basically, as you know, all the theorems just like a tools to analyze the circuit. And analysis means what? Analysis means to find out the value of the voltage, current and different parameter in the circuit. And what are those parameters? Those parameters may be the resistance, it may be the inductance, and may be the capacitance. So just we are taking a one circuit, as you can see in the diagram, and this circuit will be analyzed by the mesh analysis, by the Thevenin theorem, by the Norton theorem, and superposition theorem. So as I already told you that all these theorems just like a tools. That means any tools can be used to analyze the particular circuit. So first of all, we are going to discuss about the mesh analysis. So what are the steps in the mesh analysis? First is identify the number of meshes in the network, right? Suppose in this particular circuit there are three meshes. So you just note down or write mesh 1, mesh 2, mesh 3, and assume the different mesh current, or you can say the loop current. Second step is assign the current direction for the each mesh, then develop the KVL, that is Kirchhoff's voltage law for the each mesh, and by solving the KVL equation, find out the loop current. So here you can see that in this particular circuit, there are two types of energy sources are there. One is ideal voltage source and another is ideal current source. So what you will do now, because you are going to apply the mesh analysis, so in this particular mesh, just you assume that this loop current I1 is flowing, and in this particular mesh you assume that current I2 is flowing. So just you apply the KVL in mesh 1. So what will happen? The polarity of this 15 volt is what? Minus and plus. This current I1 is flowing from this direction to this direction. That means there will be a voltage drop due to this 4 ohm resistance and current I1. Again there will be one voltage drop due to this 2 ohm resistance. And what is the net amount of current is flowing through this 2 ohm resistance? That is I1 minus I2. So when you are considering mesh 1, just to assume that this loop current I1 is higher than this current I2. So net current will be what? I1 minus I2, which will flow from top to bottom. So what will be the voltage drop? One voltage drop due to this 4 ohm resistance multiplied by current I1. Another voltage drop due to this 2 ohm resistance multiplied by current I1 minus I2. So assuming current I1 and I2 in mesh 1 and mesh 2, in mesh 1 just we apply the KVL. So 15 minus 2 plus is plus 15 minus 4 I1. Then again it is a drop due to this 2 ohm resistance, and net current, as I already told you, that is I1 minus I2. So it is minus 2 I1 minus I2 is equal to 0. So after solving this expression, so final expression will come 6 I1 minus 2 I2 is equal to 15. Just you assume this is equation number 1, right? Now you have to apply in the KVL in this mesh. So there is this I2 is current is flowing. So in 3 ohm resistance, there is a two currents are flowing. One is I2 current, another is 6 ampere current. So net current flowing through this 3 ohm resistance is equal to what? This 6 ampere current plus I2. And same current is flowing in 5 ohm resistance. That means voltage drop this 5 ohm resistance is equal to what? 5 multiplied by I2 plus 6. So just you apply the KVL in mesh 2. You can start from anywhere. You can start from this point. You can start from this point, or you can start from this point. So we are starting from this point. So here current is what? This I2 current, this loop current, plus this 6 ampere current due to this current source. So net current is what? 6 plus I2. So there will be voltage drop. So it can be written as minus 3 into I2 plus 6, right? Again, there will be a voltage drop due to this 5 ohm resistance. It can be written as minus. Minus is representing, that means there is a drop in the voltage. So minus 5 multiplied by I2 plus 6. Then this 2 ohm resistance, again current is flowing in this 2 ohm resistance is what? There is a two current is flowing, I1 and I2. Now because you are assuming this mesh 2 and you assume that this I2 current is higher than this I1 current. So if I2 current is higher than I2, so what will be the net current? It will be called I2 minus I1, which will be flow from this direction to this direction, right? So it can be written as minus 2 I2 minus I1. So net equation is equal to what? Minus 2 I1 plus 10 I2 is equal to minus 48. And just you write that this equation is a number 2. Now you have a two equations, you have a two unknown, that is I1, I2. So you can easily calculate these two equations and you can easily find out the value of current I1 and I2. So by solving equation number 1 and 2, you get the value of current I1, it comes 0.964 ampere, and value of current I2 is equal to what? Minus 4.607 ampere. What is the meaning of this minus? Because current can be a minus. This minus is showing the only direction of the current. That means what the direction you are assuming, just you have taken in the opposite direction. That means this current must be flowing from this direction to this direction. So you have to find out the current in 5 ohm resistance. So current flowing through 5 ohm resistance is equal to what? This current, loop current I2, plus 6 ampere current due to this current source. So net current flowing through this 5 ohm resistance is equal to what? I2 plus 6. So it can be written as I2 plus 6. And what is the value of this I2? Value of this I2 is minus 4.607. You put here. So you come, you get the current that is flowing through 5 ohm resistance is 1.392 ampere. Just you remember this value, because same circuit will be analyzed by the another method, and just you have to cross check whether you are getting the same current when you are going to apply the different tools, right? So this you have to remember that current flowing through 5 ohm resistance is 1.392 ampere. Now we are going to apply the Thevenin theorem in same circuit. So as per Thevenin theorem, what Thevenin theorem state that? Thevenin theorem state that any two terminal bilateral active network can be replaced by simple Thevenin voltage in series with Thevenin equivalent resistance. And what is Thevenin voltage? Thevenin voltage is nothing but it is a open circuit voltage across two terminal into a network while all independent energy sources are replaced by their internal resistance. And what is internal resistance of ideal voltage source? That is zero. That means you can replace that voltage source by the short circuit. And what is the internal resistance of ideal current source? It is infinite. Infinite means what? Open circuit. That means if there is an ideal current source in any particular circuit can be, that ideal current source can be replaced by the open circuit. So now we can understand what are the steps that you have to follow when you are going to apply the Thevenin theorem. So first step is what? Calculate the open circuit voltage across the load terminal. That is, you can say that terminal can be termed at A and B. Then you have to calculate the equivalent resistance. What is that equivalent resistance? That equivalent resistance is nothing but it is a Thevenin equivalent resistance across the load terminals, right? Then you have to find out the Thevenin equivalent circuit and calculate the current using the KVL in that particular loop. So Thevenin voltage is open circuit voltage across the two terminal. Thevenin equivalent resistance is the equivalent resistance looking from two terminal into a network while all independent energy sources are replaced by their internal resistance. So as you can see, this was the initial circuit that it was analyzed previously by the mesh analysis. Now this circuit is going to be analyzed with help of the Thevenin theorem. That means you have to find out the current through this 5 ohm resistance. So you can treat this 5 ohm resistance as a load resistance. So what is the first step? Just you replace this load resistance from this circuit and you make this is as a open circuit. So after the removing this 5 ohm resistance, this circuit can be replaced like this. So here you can see this 5 ohm resistance is replaced from this particular circuit. So this is a 2 terminal, you can say this is a terminal, this is a B terminal. So whatever the voltage you will get across these 2 terminal, it will be called the open circuit voltage, or you can say it is a Thevenin voltage. So our aim is what? To get the Thevenin voltage. That is the first step. Now what will be the Thevenin voltage across this terminal? So here you can see, because there is no current is flowing through this 3 ohm resistance because it is open circuit, so that means there is no voltage drop across 3 ohm resistance. That means polarity at this voltage, or you can say value of voltage at this node is equal to voltage at this node. That means potential at this node is equal to potential at this node, right? And this one is a reference node, you can easily see. So potential at this node is equal to potential at this node. That means whatever the voltage drop across this 2 ohm resistance are there, that will be the open circuit voltage, or you can say Thevenin voltage, right? Now you have to find out the voltage drop across this 2 ohm resistance. So just you apply the KVL. So what will be the current? Just you assume that this I2 current is flowing due to this 15 volt voltage source. Another, because there is a 6 ampere current source is also are there. So that means this 6 ampere current will flow from here to this direction, and this current will go through this 2 ohm resistance also. So what will be the net current that will flow this 2 ohm resistance? That is I2 plus 6. Or sorry, this current is I1. That means I1 plus 6. So just you apply the KVL in this equation. So polarity of this 15 volt voltage source is what? Minus 2 plus. So you can write minus 2 plus will always be written as positive. So it can write 15. Now because I1 current is flowing through this 4 ohm resistance, so there will be some voltage drop in 4 ohm resistance. And what will be this voltage drop? It can be written as 4I1. So just you assume it is a plus, this is minus. So current is flowing from plus to minus, that means there is a drop. So you can write as minus 4I1. Now you have to find out the voltage drop this 2 ohm resistance. What is the net current that is flowing through 2 ohm resistance in this condition when it is open circuit? That is I1 plus 6. So what will be the voltage drop? 2 multiplied by 6 plus I1 is equal to 0. So after the solving, you can easily calculate the value of current I1. This current is coming 0.5 ampere, right? Now what will be the open circuit voltage? Open circuit voltage will be voltage drop across this 2 ohm resistance. So VOC is equal to what? 2 ohm multiplied by I1 plus 6. Here you can see, just, or you can say apply the KVL in this particular mesh. So VOC is equal to what? Minus 2 plus is plus VOC, minus 3 into current flowing through this 3 ohm resistance. Because it is open circuit, that means there is no voltage drop across 3 ohm resistance. So you can neglect voltage drop across this one. So minus 2 plus VOC minus 2 I1 plus 6 is equal to 0. So just put the value of I1 is equal to what? 0.5. So it comes 6.5. So VOC is equal to what? 13 voltage. So this VOC is a Thevenin voltage, and value of this Thevenin voltage is equal to what? 13 voltage. So Thevenin voltage is what? Thevenin voltage is nothing. It is a open circuit voltage across two terminal when it is being open circuited, right? So now first step, that you have calculated the Thevenin voltage. Next step is you have to find the Thevenin equivalent resistance. How to calculate the Thevenin equivalent resistance? Thevenin equivalent resistance is calculated as you have to look from two terminal. And what are those terminal? A and B. So Thevenin equivalent resistance is the equivalent resistance looking from two terminal into a network while all independent energy sources are replaced by their internal resistance. So In this circuit, there was a two independent energy source. One is ideal voltage source, so it is replaced by short circuit. Another is a independent current source, that means it is replaced by open circuit. So in this particular condition, if you have to find the what is the equivalent resistance. So just you assume, now you have to see which resistance are in parallel, which are in series. So in this case, what you can do, just you assume that one imaginary current is flowing. Like assume that, suppose any current, you can say that I1 dash is currently flowing. So this I1 dash current will be divided in two paths, one in this path, another is this path. So when current divide in any path, you can say that means that two branches are in parallel, right? And remaining equivalent resistance of these two branches are in series with 3 ohm. So what is the equivalent resistance of these two branches? 4 ohm and 2 ohm, 4 into 2 upon 4 plus 2. Equivalent of this you can add with 3 ohm resistance. So 4 is parallel with 2 added with 3 ohm resistance. So it comes 4.33 ohm. So value of Thevenin resistance is what? RTH is equal to 4.33 ohm. Now you have calculate the Thevenin voltage. You have also calculated Thevenin resistance, Thevenin voltage. So just you make the Thevenin equivalent circuit. Here you can see Thevenin voltage is 13 volt. Thevenin resistance is 4.33 ohm. Now what the resistance, that is a load resistance that you had replaced, you put here. Now this Thevenin resistance and load resistance are connected in series with the Thevenin voltage, and you have to find out the load current IL that is flowing through this 5 ohm resistance, because these two resistances are connected in a parallel. So you can say this total resistance will work as a load on this Thevenin voltage, 13 voltage, or you can say simply just you apply in the KVL in this particular mesh. So IL can be written as VOC. VOC is nothing but that is Thevenin voltage divided by RTH plus RL. Value of RTH is equal to what? 4.33 ohm, and value of load resistance RL is equal to what? 5 ohm. So after the putting all the value, you are able to calculate 1.39 ampere. So you can notice that this 1.39 ampere current was also calculated with help of the mass analysis. That means for analyzing the any circuit, you can apply the any tools. It depends which one is easier at that particular time. Easier means what? Suppose in this particular circuit, this resistance was the variable resistance. Like suppose now I am saying that now you calculate the current when load resistance is 10 ohm. Then I am saying now you calculate the current load current when load resistance is 15 ohm. That means you are not supposed to apply KVL and KCL again and again. Once you are able to calculate the Thevenin voltage and Thevenin resistance, that means these two values are the fixed. What the value that are going to be changed, that is a load resistance. This means after the putting this variable resistance, you can easily calculate the load resistance. At that time, this Thevenin theorem will be very useful. Now, same circuit will be analyzed with the Norton theorem. What Norton theorem states that any two terminal bilateral active network can be replaced by Norton current source in parallel with Norton equivalent resistance. And what is Norton current? Norton current is nothing, it is a short circuit current through the terminal. And what is a Norton equivalent resistance? Norton equivalent resistance is same as Thevenin resistance, or you can say it is equivalent resistance looking from two terminal into a network, while all independent energy sources are replaced by their internal resistance. I am again and again saying internal resistance of ideal voltage source is zero. Zero means it has to be replaced by the short circuit, and internal resistance of ideal current source is infinite. Infinite means you have to replace by open circuit. Suppose there is some voltage source and some internal resistance, let small r1 is given. That means you have to replace that particular voltage source by that internal resistance r1, right? Now you have to draw the Norton equivalent circuit and calculate the node current using the current divider rule. So this was the initial circuit. that we have already calculated load current 5 ohm resistance with the help of the mesh analysis, and we have also calculated with the help of the Norton, with the help of Thevenin theorem. Now we are going to calculate in Norton current, load current in 5 ohm resistance with the help of the Norton theorem. So what is the first step? You replace this 5 ohm resistance from this circuit and make it short circuit by some wire which have zero resistance, right? So zero resistance means short circuit. So this is a two terminal A and B, it is shorted by some wire, and you have to find out value of this current. So in this particular case, you can say I2 current is equal to the short circuit current, right? So here you can see that this circuit has been replaced into this circuit. How? Because here you can see there is a 6 ampere current having a parallel resistance 2M. So that means you can say this is a current source, and this current source can be converted into equivalent voltage source. How to convert this current source into voltage source? Multiply this current into this resistance, means value of the resistance which is connected opposite to the 6 ampere current source. So what will be the value of voltage? 6 into 2, that is 12 volt, and current is flowing from lower to upper side, that means this terminal will be negative, this terminal will be positive, and this resistance will come in series with that particular voltage. So this particular path, this particular branch, or you can say current source, is converted into voltage source. Now you can easily apply the KVL in this particular circuit. So you have to calculate the Norton current, or you can say short circuit current. That means you have to find out this current I2. So assume current I1 and I2 in loop 1 and loop 2. The short circuit current ISC, or you can say IN, is equal to what? I2. So by applying the KVL in loop 1, you can write minus 2 plus is plus 15, minus 4 I1 minus 12, because again it is a polarity from plus 2 minus 15, minus 4 I1 minus 12. Again there is a voltage drop in this 2 ohm resistance. So what is the current that is flowing in 2 ohm resistance? That is I1 minus I2. And just you assume that this I1 current is more than current I2, that means net current is equal to what? I1 minus I2. So finally you can write 15 minus 4 I1 minus 12 minus 2 into I1 minus I2 is equal to 0. So after the solving this particular expression, you can write equation 6 I1 minus 2 I2 is equal to 3. You assume that this is equation number 1. Now because you have to find the current I2, and this I2 is nothing but it is a short circuit current, just apply the KVL in this loop, and you can start from any point. You can start from this point, you can start from this point. So just you can write minus 2 plus 2 minus, that means minus 3 I2, right? Minus 2 I2 minus I1, then minus 2 plus is plus, plus 12 is equal to 0. You can see here in this particular slide. By applying the KVL in loop 2, that is minus 2 plus is plus 12, minus 3 I2, minus 2 I2 minus I1 is equal to 0. So finally this expression can be solved, and it can be written as minus 2 I1 plus 5 I2 is equal to 12. Now you have a two equation, two unknown, so you can very easily calculate. You can either apply by the Cramer rule or just simply algebraic, because you have a two algebraic equation and you can easily solve. So after the solving this equation 1 and 2, you get the value of current I1 is equal to 1.5 ampere and current I2 is equal to 3 ampere. So this I2 is equal to what? This I2 is nothing but it is a short circuit current or Norton current, that is called short circuit current, and it comes 3 ampere. Now you have calculated the Norton current, you have already calculated the Norton equivalent resistance. So just you made the Norton equivalent circuit and put the value of load resistance here. The method to calculate the Norton equivalent resistance is the same as the Thevenin resistance. Norton equivalent resistance is the equivalent resistance looking from two terminal into a network, while all independent energy sources are replaced by their internal resistance. So again this value comes 4.33 ohm. Now you may make the Norton equivalent current. So this Norton current, value of Norton current is what? 3 ampere, and Norton equivalent resistance is 4.33 ohm, and this is a load resistance in which you have to calculate the current. You can say this current is a IL current, or you can say this current is a IAB current. So how you can calculate this load current IAB? Just you apply the current division rule. What current division rule is state that this current IAB can be calculated as total current. What is the total current? 3 ampere multiplied by resistance of opposite branch. So opposite of this branch is what? This node resistance, Norton resistance 4.33. So ISC multiplied by RN upon resistance of these two branches, summation of resistance of these two branches. That means 4.33 plus 5. So again it comes 1.392 ampere. So you have noticed that when you are calculating load current in 5 ohm resistance, either you are calculating with the superposition theorem, or you are calculating with mesh analysis, or you are calculating with the Norton theorem, or you are calculating with the Thevenin theorem, same current is coming, that is 1.392 ampere. So this is how you can cross check that all theorems can be applied or not, or you can validate all the theorems. Now same question can be solved with the superposition theorem also. What superposition theorem state that any two terminal bilateral active linear network, in linear network, current or voltage in any particular branch is equal to the algebraic sum of response when one source considered at a time when remaining sources are replaced by their internal resistance. So we can calculate the current through each branch by considering one source at a time. If another source is an ideal voltage source, then it must be short circuited, while if other source is an ideal current source, then it must be open circuited. The similar procedure is followed with the another source. The current through any branch is the algebraic sum of the current considering due to individual source. So here you can see that you are going to calculate the net current through this 5 ohm resistance. So you have to consider one source at a time. So you are considering this 15 volt voltage source. So what we will do? You have to replace this 6 ampere current source. And internal resistance of 6 ampere current is what? Because it is ideal current source, that means internal resistance is infinite. So you can replace this 6 ampere current source as a open circuit. Right? Now you find the value of the current in this particular circuit. So initially the current is distributed as shown in the figure. That current is I1. If this current is I2, so this current will be what? I1 minus I2. So just by applying the KVL in loop 1, it will be minus 2 plus is 15, minus 4 I1, minus 2 I1 minus I2 is equal to 0. So you get the equation 6 I1 minus 2 I2 is equal to 15. Now you apply the KVL in loop 2. So you can write, you can start from any point. So just you write, suppose this 5 and 3 are in series, so you can directly written as 5 plus 3 is 8 ohm, minus 8 I2, because in this branch current is flowing is I2. So it can be written as minus 8 I2 minus 2 I2 minus I1 is equal to 0. So after the solving, you get this equation, minus 2 I1 plus 10 I2 is equal to 0. Now you have again two equations, two unknowns, so you can easily solve these two equations. So the current is coming, I1 is equal to 2.678 ampere and I2 is 0.5357 ampere. You can term this current as IAB dash, right? Because we are interested to know the current through 5 ohm resistance only. So just you assume that this IAB dash current is the current when you consider 15 volt voltage source when remaining sources was replaced by their internal resistance. Now second step is what? You have to consider this source and you have to replace another source, that is ideal voltage source, by the short circuit. So just you make the short circuit here. So you apply the current division rule here. So here you can see that this 4 ohm and 2 ohm resistance are in parallel, right? and these two resistance are in series, so you calculate the equivalent resistance of this one and calculate the equivalent resistance of this one. So by using the current divider rule, the current across resistor connected across branch AB, because we are interested to know only the current branch AB, and this current can be termed as IAB double dash. So IAB double dash is equal to what? This 6 ampere current will be divided in this branch and in this branch. So current through this branch IAB double dash is equal to what? 6, that is a current, multiplied by resistance of opposite of this branch. Opposite of this branch is what? That is a 1.33 ohm. So 6 into 1.33 upon summation of resistance of two branches, that is 1.33 plus 8. So this IAB double dash comes 0.855 ampere. So as per the superposition theorem, it is said that in any particular branch, the current, net current is equal to the algebraic sum of the current, because direction of the current IAB dash and IAB double dash are the same, so that means it can be simply added. So IAB is equal to what? 0.855 plus 0.5357. So you can notice here then that current, again this current is coming 1.39 ampere. So in this particular circuit we have we can conclude that by applying any of the method you can calculate the current, and you are by this means you can also validate the mesh analysis, you can validate the Thevenin theorem, you can validate the Norton theorem as well as the superposition theorem. Now we have to understand the KVL and KCL. So what KVL state that? KVL state that algebraic sum of voltage in any particular mesh is equal to zero. And what KCL state that? KCL state that at any particular node or junction is equal to zero. That means algebraic sum of current at any particular node is equal to zero. Or in another word, you can say the incoming current at any particular node is equal to the outgoing current, right? So now this figure 1 can be converted in this form. Just you assume the different current, and you give, just you put the name of the different branch current. You start from this branch, let this current is I1. Now suppose this is a net I1 current is flowing from G to A. Again this I1 current is I1, and let assume that I2 is a some part of this current I1. So if this current is I2, so what will be the value of current in branch BC? Because this current is I1 and this is I2, so this will be what? I1 minus I2. Or you can cross check here, just you apply the KCL at particular node B. So this is an incoming current and these are the two outgoing currents. So I1 is equal to what? I2 plus I1 minus I2. So I2 and I2 is cancelled. So it is I1. That means incoming current is equal to outgoing current. So how to apply KVL? Just you assume this current is I1 and you assume that I2 current is going in this branch. So this current will be what? This I1 minus I2. Again here you can see there is a 6 ampere current source are also there. If this is I1 minus I2, so this is I1 minus I2, and this 6 ampere current is also coming. So at this particular, in this particular branch, what will be the value of current? This current plus this current. So it is minus I1, I1 minus I2 plus 6, right? Now again you assume this current is I3 current. So this I3 current can be assumed that this is a part of this current. That means this I3 current is coming from this current. So what will be the current flowing through this branch DEF? It will be I1 minus I2 plus I6 minus I3, right? Now you have to find out the current in this branch, because this current is I2, this current is 6 ampere. So what is the value of this current? I2 minus I6, because 6 ampere is flowing, 6 ampere is, let assume it is a part of this I2. So this current is I2 minus I6. Again you apply the KCL at node H. So this I2 minus 6 is an incoming current. I3 is also incoming current. This is outgoing current. So this outgoing current must be equal to algebraic sum of this current. That means what will be value of this current? I3 plus I2 minus 6, or you can say I2 minus 6 plus I3. Again you apply the KCL at node F. This is also incoming current, this is also incoming current, this is outgoing current. So value of this current I1 is equal to what? I2 minus 6 plus I3 plus I1 minus I2 plus 6 minus I3, so it come I1. So this is how you can apply the KCL. Now you have to apply the KVL in particular meshes. So you can see here there are three meshes. One is this one, another is this one, and another is this one. So just you apply the mesh in various meshes. So first mesh you can say B, that means this B, C, D, H, B. You apply the mesh in this. So as per the KVL, just you apply, if current is flowing in any branch, so it can be written as a drop. What will you drop? Suppose you are want to calculate drop in this 2 ohm resistance. So it will be what? I1 minus I2 into 2, right? So you start from this point, or you can start from this branch, or you can start from this point. So here we are starting minus 2 multiplied by current I1 minus I2. Then this branch, because there is no resistance in this branch, again there is a 10 ohm resistance are connected in branch between terminal D and B. So what will we drop? 10 into I3, so it can be written as minus 10 I3. Again, because we are starting in this direction from C, D, H, B. Now you have assumed current flowing in this branch is opposite what you are assuming, so it will be taken as a positive. So what will be the drop in this 1 ohm resistance? It is a 1 into I2 minus 6 is equal to 0. Similarly, you can apply the KVL in D, E, F, H and D. You can start from any point. So you can start, suppose, from this point. So it will be minus 2 into I1 minus I2 plus 6 minus I3. Then plus 2 minus, that means minus, minus 10. Then again this direction is opposite, so it can be written as plus 3 into I2 minus 6 plus I3. Again direction is opposite, it can be written as plus 10 into I3. So you will get this equation. Because there is a 10 voltage source, so you will get this final expression. Minus 2 into I1 minus I2 plus 6 minus I3 plus 3 I2 minus 6 plus I3 plus 10 I3 equal to 10. Now you apply the KVL in this mesh. B, H, F, G and A. So it can be written as minus I2 minus 6 into 1 minus 3 into I2 minus 6 plus I3 minus 4 into I1 minus 2 plus is plus plus 24 is equal to 0. So finally you can write equation this: minus 1 into I2 minus 6 minus 3 multiplied by I2 minus 6 plus I3 minus 4 I1 equal to minus 24. So now you have a three equation. After the rearranging previous three equation, you can write equation in this form. So just value, you write the equation in the matrix form. This will be called resistance matrix, this will be called current matrix, this will be called voltage matrix. So just coefficient of I1, I2 and I3 can be written in this matrix, in this matrix, and this column matrix of current I1, I2, 3, this is a voltage matrix which is represented by one column. Now you have to find out the value of, suppose, current I1. So I1 can be calculated by applying the Cramer rule. And as per Cramer rule, this I1 can be calculated as delta 1 upon delta. And what is a delta? Delta is nothing but it's a determinant of this matrix. So you have to calculate the determinant of this matrix. And delta 1 is what? Delta 1 means column of this first column of this matrix is replaced by this column. So what will be the next column? It will be the minus 6, minus 40, 48, minus 3, minus 5, 4, plus 10, minus 15, 3. So I1 can be calculated as delta 1 upon delta. So delta can be calculated as, and this after solving you get the value 568, and delta 1 is what? First column of first matrix is replaced by the column of the voltage matrix. After the solving you get the value of delta 1 is 2330. So as per Cramer rule, I1 is equal to what? Delta 1 upon delta. So you will get the value 4.1 ampere. Similarly, you can calculate the branch current I2. You can calculate the branch current I3. What will be the I2? I2 is equal to nothing but it is a delta 2 upon delta, and I3 is equal to what? Delta 3 upon delta. Now we are going to apply the nodal analysis. So in the nodal analysis, what you have to do? You have to mark the different nodes. So you can see here in the diagram, this one node is this one, that is a node A, another node is this one, node B, another node is node C, and another node is a node D. Node D can be taken as a reference node, or you can say ground node, right? So just you apply the KCL at node A. So here you can see that I1, I2 and I3 are the outgoing current, and I is the incoming current. So incoming current is equal to the outgoing current. So incoming current is I, and outgoing current is I3, I2 and I1. So just put the value of I1, I2, I3 here. So what is the value of this I1? I1 is current flowing from node A to D. That means potential of node A is higher than potential of node D. So I1 is equal to what? BA minus BD upon 2. And what is the value of I2? I2 is current flowing from node A to B. So it can be written as I2 is equal to BA minus BB upon 3. And what is I3? I3 is current flowing from node A to C. That means potential of node A is higher than potential of node C. So I3 is equal to VA minus BC upon 5. So just put the value of this I1, I2 and I3 in this particular expression, and you, after the solving, you will get final expression 31 VA minus 10 VB minus 6 BC is equal to 300. This is equation number 1. Now you apply the KCL at node B here. So here you can see that I2 is incoming current, I5 is outgoing current, I4 is outgoing current. So what you can write, or you can say algebraic sum of current at any particular node is equal to 0. So it can be written as I2 minus I4 minus Y5 is equal to 0. What is the value of I2? I2 is equal to VA minus BB, because current is flowing from A to B. So I2 is VA minus BB upon 3, and I4 is what? Current is flowing from node B to node C. So it can be written as VB minus BC upon 1, and current I5 is flowing from node B to node D, and potential of node D is 0. So of course this current I5 is equal to what? VB upon 5. Put the value of this I2, I4 and I5, and after the solving you will get the final expression, that is 5BA minus 23BB plus 15BC is equal to 0. You assume that this is equation number 2. Now you have another node, that is node C. You have to apply the node KCL at node C. So here you can see there are 4 branch current. One is I4, which is a incoming current. Another is I3, which is also incoming current. And another is I6, which is outgoing current. And another is I7, which is outgoing current. And value of this I7 is what? 2 ampere. So just you apply the KCL at this node, algebraic sum of current at any particular node or junction is equal to 0. So it can be written as I3 plus I4 minus I6 minus I7 is equal to 0. Just you put the value of I3, I4, I6 and I7. What is the I3? I3 is current flowing from node A to C. That means VA minus VC divided by this resistance. So it can be written as VA minus VC upon 5. Now I4. I4 is flowing from B to C. So it can be written as VB minus BC upon resistance of this branch 1, and I7 is what? I7 is a 2 ampere, it can be written as a 2, and I6 is what? I6 is current flowing from node C to D, so it can be written as BC upon BC minus BD, and potential of VD is 0. So this I6 is equal to what? BC upon 4. So after the solving this final expression, you can write 4BA plus 20VV minus 29VC is equal to 40. Now again, it can be written as equation 3. Now we have a 3 equation, 3 unknown, so you can easily find out. Simply you can solve by the algebra, as you solve with the linear equation, or you can solve by the Cramer rule. So just you use these 3 equation, you write this equation in the matrix form. So these are the coefficient of these 3 equation: 31 minus 10 minus 6 is a coefficient of BA, BB, BC in equation number, you can say equation number 4, and 5 minus 23 and 15 is a coefficient of equation number 2, and 4, 20 minus 29 are the coefficient of BA, BB, BC in equation number 6. So you can easily write this equation in this form. Now you have to find out the value, suppose VA. So VA is equal to what? Delta 1 upon delta, or you can say that D naught upon delta, D1. So what you have to do? You have to find out the D naught. D naught is a determinant of this matrix. So you can easily calculate value of this D naught. D1 is what? D1 means this column is replaced by this column. So again you will get the new matrix, and this matrix will be what? 300, 0, 40, minus 10, minus 6, minus 23, 15, 20, 29. And you calculate the determinant of value. So I1 is equal to, V1 is equal to what? D1 upon D0. Similarly, you can calculate the D2, D3. So BA is equal to what? D1 upon D0. BB is equal to what? D2 upon D0. And BC is equal to D3 upon D0. So now you are able to calculate the node voltage VA, VV and VC. Now because you are interested to know the different current, so suppose this we want to calculate current I. So I is what? 10 ampere. I7 is what? 2 ampere. Now suppose you are interested to know the value of current I1. So I1 is equal to what? VA minus BD upon 2. VA, you have a value of VA is 12.06, BD is 0, so 12.06 minus 0 divided by 2, so you will calculate the current I1. And I2 is equal to what? BA minus BB upon 3. I4 is equal to what? BB minus BC upon 1. I6 is equal to what? BC minus BD upon 4. So now you have all the values of the VA, BB, BC. Just you put the value in this equation and you can easily calculate the different branch current. Suppose it is asked that you find out the voltage, so you can also find out the voltage here. Current multiplied by 2, or you can say BA minus BD is the potential difference between these two nodes. Suppose it is asked you find out the power losses in 2 ohm resistance. So power losses in 2 ohm resistance is equal to what? I1 square into 2 ohm, and you have already calculated the I1, so just put the value, you can easily calculate the current. So in this particular session we have discussed how to apply the mesh analysis, how to apply the nodal analysis, how to apply the Thevenin theorem, and how to apply the Norton theorem. So this is a very interesting tools to analyze the circuit. And I already told you that analysis means you have to find out the value of the current, value of the voltage. At the same time, you can easily find out the different electrical parameter of the circuit, like resistance, inductance and capacitance. Thank you so much.